But we also, and I'm preaching to the choir, have to have those prayer strategies that the Lord gives us to see whatever principalities are over areas and regions, to see them defeated. I love the testimony that he shared today about Timothy. Is actually in my book. I'm like, oh. But he was, I don't like that Timothy was persecuted. I don't like that he was killed. But what did he say? He said that it happened in front of the temple of Diana and Artemis, a form of the Queen of Heaven. So he wants us to be ones that no matter what the cost and no matter what the price. But then what did John do when that happened? He goes into that temple. He confronts that principality and it splits in two and it's defeated. I want to see an altar split in two when I'm praying. I will tell you one that we have seen. We went into Berlin and the Lord told us to pray at the Ishtar Gate in Berlin. And we did. And 6 months to the day that we were there praying for that gate to shut down, the whole entire Pergamum Museum, because they also have the seat of Satan in there at the Ishtar Gate, literally is shut down because the whole museum is sinking. Come on! Okay, a whole museum sinking. That's pretty cool. You know why it's sinking? They built those artifacts into the structure of the building. They can't remove them, and the building cannot contain the weight. 6 months to the day. And we said, Ishtar Gate, you are shut down. It would have been kind of cool if it started doing that when we were there. You know, we might have been running out, but come on, guys. And so he says, Jesus said to the disciples in Acts 1:8. But I promise you this, Holy Spirit will come upon you and you will be seized with power. And I know I've shared that word here, lambano. It means that he seizes us, but there's us that are seizing what he is giving us. It's a twofold action of that seizing. And it means that we will be seized with power. This word power, dunamis. It's the ability to perform an act. It's power. Power is the capacity to do something. Authority is the right. Power is the ability or capacity to do something. Authority is the right. We got both. All authority in heaven and earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples. I give to you authority to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means injure you. I'm not talking about presumptuous, but what I'm talking about is when he has called you corporately, when he's called you in an assignment in the region, not only is it for the harvest of souls, but it is to see all the demonic structures that the enemy has set up, to see them defeated, conquered, and dethroned. People are like, ooh, Becca, that's dangerous. Okay, so was Jesus. So were the disciples. So were the apostles. Paul walked into a city and turned it upside down for the kingdom of God. Just his presence, his prayer, his teaching. There would be a confrontation even when he wasn't looking for one. And sometimes we think that's a negative thing. It's the exact opposite. It's a great thing. Why is it a great thing? Because the fire in you, the fire in him, caused those demons to manifest. They could not contain themselves. Because one thing the enemy doesn't know how to do in his army of darkness is to lay low. When somebody of greater power and authority shows up and starts to mess up the atmosphere, it's going to manifest. They're going to manifest, and they're going to try to overplay their hand, and you're like, thank you so much. Now you're going. Woo! It means this dunamis, I know, right? That's part of what's happening. You got it. You got, whoop, yep. You got it. Sometimes we think, oh, man, all of a sudden there's a stirring up and there's this chaos that has started to happen. Praise God, you're doing something right. And that's the exact time we continue to press through to break through instead of backing up and shrinking away. This word dunamis means a mighty deed. It means a ruler, meaning that we have that authority that we just talked about. Are you guys good? It means a supernatural power. It means a supernatural army. The army of God and the army of the enemy. And we know who wins. I know you guys have heard me say this. We're not fighting for victory, but from victory with victory. Jesus has already appropriated this victory. And he says that I promise you this, the Holy Spirit will come upon you and you will be seized with power and you will be my messengers. And that means that we are going to be those. You guys were already sharing about that this afternoon so beautifully.